So good evening. We are back again. World-class, scary and unstoppable Arsenal are into the hat, into the draw tomorrow. Nusa, what are you saying? What are you telling me, bro?
I'm good. I was just seeing Mo crying, the Egyptian quagmire, absolutely in bits. I'm loving it. You know what I mean? I'm loving it. Big up to Mo. But remember, do you remember when you told me maybe my standards are a bit too high for my football club? Bro, this isn't the treble-winning Inter Milan. This isn't Jose Mourinho, calma. You know what I mean? I'm not of the bottle. I'm not one of the bottle. You are of the bottle. You know what I mean? Listen.
Staffy had him on the string. Staffy called him and said, yeah, you're now called Outer Milan. Yeah, none of this Inter Milan. You're not Outer. What was his name? Who's your daddy? Who's your daddy about Arsenal, yeah? Hussam had him on strings, bruv. Who is your daddy? Yeah, he goes, who's your daddy? I was like, nah, I sent him a voice message like, yo, who's your daddy? Yeah, now you're the bitch.
Yeah.
Bro, there's content for days there, mate. Trust me. Content for days there, bro.
Trust me. We have to, though. Do you know what I'm saying? Your boy Barella, missing. You know what I mean? Your boy Taram, missing. Do you know what I'm saying? Martinez, 100 million pound valuation for that striker. Oh, I'm loving it. Now you're looking like the African John Travolta online on stream, flipping out, bro. It's lovely. Because every Friday,
I don't know why he's going so crazy. Why is he so upset, bro? They're top of the league. Just be happy. They've already won a cup this season. Just be happy.
Yep.
16 points clear. 16. It's not like they're 1 point clear or drawing. They're 16 points clear and they've won a cup this season. Just be happy.
I'm grateful.
Yeah, it's disgusting, man. Fake fan. Why don't you just fuck off to AC Milan? Yeah. Don't even need to change stadiums.
Oh,
if you can't see what Internet are doing, you can F off down the San Siro to the red side.
I'm just going to keep singing to him, Barella, forever. You know what I mean? Forever. You know what I mean? Forever and ever. Because at the end of the day, it's so funny. Everything people tell you, when they're watching their team and their team ain't achieving, it's always different. It always hits different. It's easy telling somebody else to be, maybe you have to look at it this angle, that angle. I remember when he told me the ownership at Arsenal, maybe they're just happy. This is where they want the club to be. Well, maybe your ownership just wants Inter Milan to just be, you know, in the mix, putting the pressure on. That's it. You know what I mean? So, listen, it is what it is, man. It is what it is, Mo. I'm loving it, man.
You're right. When people are watching their own teams, it's the truth comes out, guys. The truth comes out. Just be happy. Just back them. They're doing well. Yeah. My mum was sitting there saying, "F Alexis Sanchez. F whoever signed him. F this ownership." What do you mean? Who signed him? Like, what? He's just missed a penalty, bro. Anyone can miss a penalty. Without me, right? Just relax, calm, my guy. But it was funny because I was about 6 seconds ahead of him and I was sharing the stream. Yeah. And Lautaro Martinez stepped up. I was like, you know, he's missing, isn't it? Mm. Yeah. This guy is trash, bruv. Yeah. I was like, I know he's going to miss, bruv. I think that ball just spanked Vinny Jr. on the back of the head in training.
But you know what, Lee? I get it. Yeah. I don't know if you saw the part of his stream where he started blaming VAR. He started blaming the time that was added on. He started blaming the referee, saying the referee was stinky. I was like, you're sounding a lot like a top red. But then again, it makes sense because you're always acting like you're Arteta's defense lawyer. So at the same time, it makes sense, bro. Why are you blaming the ref? Inter had more than enough chances to bury them, but so did Atleti. Atleti, I think at the 90th minute, I think...
Kelme, man, how did he miss that chance, right? That was the last kick of the game as well. And it was funny because he came on, I was like, get my ball or a Kelme on, bro, yeah? And then the chat was lighting up, going, oh, it's going extra time. I was like, no. Raquelme's got a little sign for this lot, yeah? And then he gets that chance. I was like, he's going to do it, man. I would have looked like the greatest football fan on the planet for predicting that one, bro. But yeah, instead, I'm toxic and negative. Because I'm not on the Arsenal, a scary, world-class, unstoppable and scintillating.
Nah, big up to Mo, bro. You can only blame your team, man. Your team, you know what I mean? Dumfries had chances, bro. Loads of your team had chances, bro, to bury them, and you didn't take it. You didn't take it. That Barella one was disgusting. Through on goal, one-on-one, and he hits it straight at the goalkeeper. That was trash.
The Turan one as well, the Turan one. Mm. Did you see him gripping up Savage? but and then spoke to it. Like, bruv, dude, listen, no. I don't know how you're doing it over in France, bruv, yeah, but like, do you know what I'm saying? No, bruv, live on, he should have got booked for that.
Yeah, he should have, yeah.
Bro, that should have gone via, that's sexual assault, bruv. Hey, if you did that to somebody in a club, bruv, you're getting punched up.
Well, it depends what kind of club. If it's the club league, it's all right. if it's the rainbow one down in Vauxhall, you're right there. You're right. You can do that. You know what I mean? That's just saying hello. You know what I mean? Nah, my guy's looking at the French Frank Ocean, man. I'm like, nah, what are you doing, bro? What are you actually doing? But you're right, man. You're right. They got no one but themselves to blame, to be honest. And he's cussing Alexis Sanchez. What did Alexis Sanchez do? He's almost hitting 40.
Bro, he came on and he came on and actually run around, did a bit. Do you know what I'm saying? He did a job. He tried. They brought him on to do a job. He put one of them through on goal. I think he put one of them through on goal. Hey, Mkhitaryan as well, man. My man's hairline's worse than mine.
He's like, his hairline's looking like a convertible. I can't even lie, like a convertible car. I can't lie. But it's mad. Sunroof settings in his head. But yeah, it's crazy. It was what it was. I think it was a good game for the neutral. I think both teams played well, but both teams were wasteful in front of goal. That's it. And then you're leaving it down to penalties. And this is why when Arsenal went through in penalties, I don't like those kind of wins. Yeah, you can say, okay, mentality, you took them right, but it can go either way, really. Do you know what I mean? It can go either way. Do you know what I'm saying? And when you get eliminated through a pen, you'll be fuming. Because you're thinking, if only we did what we needed to do in 90 minutes and not stretching it to 120 and taking it to penalties. Do you know what I mean? Because penalties is, you need a bit of luck. You need composure and you need luck. So, yeah, it's one of them ones, man.
But at least we're in the next round, mate. Yeah, at least we're in the next round. I keep seeing people going, it's the first time in 14 years. Well, duh, we ain't been in it for 7. But another stat that makes it sound so much more amazing that Arteta's got us through. Bruv, we should be getting through. Yeah, let's be real. This fan base was shoehorning 9 players in a Madrid combined 11. So on that basis alone, we should be beating Porto. Mm. Yeah, and let's be real. The most experienced player on the pitch, yeah, if he stepped up, our goal's disallowed for offside. And we ain't getting through. Yeah, bro, we literally had 4 shots on target in 210 minutes. Yeah, and people are going, oh, but they came for a draw. Well, of course they come for a draw. Any mid block or low block that we play against, this manager struggled for 4.5 years, yeah? Right? And if, yeah, cool, we're happy, I'm in the next round and all of that good stuff, yeah? Bring on Real Madrid. Yeah, because the disrespect to them is a disgrace. Yeah? They've lost 2 games all season in all comps, and both of them are to Atleti. Yeah? Bring on Real Madrid. Their players are coming back from injury. By the time the next round's done, I think they'll have Militao back. I think Courtois done for the season, but they'll have Militao back. Yeah, and they'll have a few other players back as well. Big up Flawless, man. What are you saying, bro?
Big up, man. I'm good, man. Bless up. Apologies on the lateness. You, man, blessed, though, yeah?
Good, man. Listen, make sure you sub to both the guys' channels. Links in the title. No Saeed today. Saeed can't make it, guys. But listen, big up to everyone locked in. Let me get your thoughts on this, Flawless, yeah? Because I've seen a lot of fans, Arsenal fans, rival fans. Easy wins, bruv. Easy wins. Just get on your knees, start gnawing off Arsenal. Tell the world how great and scary they are, yeah? Tell the world they're unstoppable, they're world-class, they look the real deal, yeah? You get millions of views, bruv. Like, whether it's on Twitter, whether it's on YouTube, everyone's at it, bruv. So yeah, let me get your opinion.
I did see your tweet about that, actually, and that's the way to get views, and I was like, I quote-tweeted it with the gift, with the notepad, you know what I'm saying? I think it was little baby with the notepad. And I was like, all right, let me take notes of this and see if this works.
Video today, Arsenal was scary and unstoppable. Yeah, I guarantee you get the most views you've had for a while on a video.
Is it? That's my next title. You're
validating all the time, bruv.
That's it, though. I think what that is because your fan base has been, in particular, the social media era has been so unsuccessful for so long in terms of winning major trophies. So obviously the Premier League for 20 years, never winning the Champions League. Your fan base seeks validation so much. Not all of your fans, but not a lot of them. You know what I'm saying? There's so many who just want rival fans to praise Arsenal and tell you how great Arsenal are and how Arsenal are going to win it all. And it's like, and because you're a good side as well. So it stems from that. So I think it's validation from rival fans and also hope. But forget what rival fans think. Just let you see if your team wins, you lot do the business. That's where it's at. Like, that's what it is. Now, I'm always out here, SG, man. Unfortunately, I'm always out here. Unfortunately, man. Manchester United
man's
just
creaking,
got
bro. Man's creaking.
Always out here, man. Like, always. I wish I didn't have to watch Manchester United for real. I can't wait for the season to end. But yeah, that's what it is with Arsenal. It's the validation because of the lack of success. And that's what it is.
What I don't get, right, is who cares whether Jamie Carragher or Simon Jordan or Jamie O'Hara or any pundit or anyone, who gives two Fs, bruv, yeah, if they rate us or not? How does that stop us winning?
Yes, I get what you say, but again, you're not, but a lot of Arsenal fans don't look at it that way. Like you said, it's the validation. And because this is the first time in a long time, this is one of the best Arsenal sides in a long time. Even if whether it wins a trophy or whether it doesn't, last season you had a great season in terms of the record, even though you didn't win the league, and this season also. So belief, they say it's the hope that kills you. And Arsenal fans genuinely have hope. It's like, what, you're top of the league again by goal difference. You're through to the quarterfinals for the first time in 14 years. So this is the first time in a long time you've been in this situation. That's why I've been asking, are the stars aligning for Arsenal? This has been the conversation. Are the stars aligning?
We'll find out at the end of May.
Yeah, we'll find out. No sign were you telling me, man, the stars are lining for Arsenal.
Listen. Man, saying it's the hope that kills you. This club has resurrected me and killed me for 20 years, bro. You know what I'm saying? So they don't expect me to be saying anything like that. I think a lot of content creators want the Terry traction, bro. That's what they want, the Terry traction. You see how much traction they get? You know what I'm saying? They're like, I want a piece of that. The Terry traction. So it is what it is, man. And the funny thing is, people say that, you know, people like myself, like Lee and other real ones, we just do it for views. If we wanted to do it just for views, we'd make the same titles. You know what I mean? We'll do the same type of videos. Mm-hmm. So, because that's where all the traction's at the moment. So that's what we'll do.
Mate, I changed my title. If you look on the top of your screen, I put Arsenal scare rivals, United don't, yeah? I changed the title to Arsenal are not scary, world-class, or unstoppable. I guarantee I'd have more people watching it if I put it back to that title.
Yeah, well, with Arsenal scary rivals, and like that's where it stems from. It is validation, and obviously all fan bases want it, but it seems Arsenal in particular feel like, oh, you don't respect us. Because I get that a lot when I talk about Arsenal and say, yeah, Arsenal are a good side, I just don't think they win the Premier League, and that seems to be a major problem. It's like, no, I just don't think they're better than Manchester City. Right?
If you sit there and listen to these people that need constant validation for this football club, yeah. They tell everyone that we're amazing. They tell everyone Supermix the best in the world. Nobody's better. They tell everyone that Saka's the best right winger. Yeah, they tell everyone that Declan Rice is the best midfielder in the world. Everyone, oh, we've got great players all over the pitch, best centre backs. Okay, cool. So if we don't win the league, is it failure? No. I'm not saying that. Well, which one is it then?
That's it.
Because if they're the best at everything, then they should be winning, right?
Yes.
So if they don't, they failed.
Yeah.
No. Like, they make no sense, brother. This is why I call him out, and this is why Northside calls it out. End of the day, this club has not won anything, so stop getting so giddy.
Yeah, but again,
get giddy when we win it.
Yeah, and again, it's the hope, but that ties into shout out to Monts. He says this about Arsenal fans, and he's like, it's seek validation but avoid expectation, and that's what it is with a hell of a lot of Arsenal fans. And when he said it, I was like, you are spot on, because anytime you're even slightly, not even slightly critical, like I said, anytime I say, oh, Arsenal, I don't think Arsenal win the league. It's, oh, you hate Arsenal. It's because Manchester United is miserable. Yeah, you got an agenda. No, I just don't think you're better than Manchester City. Why is that such a crazy statement to say? I don't think you lot win the Champions League. Oh, you just hating. Why can't we win the Champions League? Do you believe Arsenal are going to win the Champions League? No. So you agree with me. You just don't like the fact that I'm saying it as a Manchester United fan. It's like, forget the messenger. What is the message type of thing? Actually, I wasn't shocked. I thought you lot would go get past Porto. I said it on this channel. I said that you lot would get past Porto. I thought it would be like in normal time, but even when it went to penalties, it was like, yeah, Arsenal have this. Because as good as Porto are, I think defensively they're exceptional. They just don't do enough going forward. Even as I was watching a game, I was like, yeah, there's half chances, but I don't see Arsenal winning. I don't see, what's it called? I don't see Porto scoring. Like, they had to be 2-0 up for me to get through to the tie. Well, yeah, again, it's seek validation, avoid it.
Do you know how you can see that they're not as confident as they say, yeah?
Go on,
when you ask Arsenal fans about the Champions League, who do you want next? Give me Dortmund.
Yeah, give me Dortmund.
Yeah? Why? But we've got to eventually beat the best. So if you don't find them in the semis, bro, you're going to find them in the finals. So what's the difference? Do you know what I'm saying? If you really believe in this process and this team, you should be like, whatever. Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Because in 06, in 06 with that Arsenal team, I didn't care who we came up against. I believed in my manager and I believed in the players. Yeah, we lost in the final, but I believed in that team. You know what I'm saying? And we came very, very close.
Yeah.
I weren't there. You've seen it with Man United. Year after year, when you lot were with Fergie, yeah, you weren't that pressed about who you get. You believed in your manager and you believed in your players.
That's true.
So you weren't really like, oh, let's see if we get the weakest team, because
it's like, oh no, we've got Real Madrid with R9. You didn't care.
Yeah. Like,
even in the league, yeah. Even in the league, they already, they're saying, okay, but what would you think if we come within 1 point, or if we take it to the wire, but we don't win? Well, hold on. You're telling me that it's negative for me to say that we're not going to win the league, but you're then now trying to justify to me if we don't win the league. But I thought we are going to win the league. You're so sure. You act like you're so sure that we're going to win the league. Why are you giving me all these alternatives if we don't win the league? I thought you're sure that we're going to win it.
Yeah.
So you don't really believe in it. But you're trying to see if you can catch me out saying, oh, as long as we're 1 point within it, because if we then bottle it, they'll say, oh, but Northside, you said if we're 1 point, or if we push him to the wire, you'll still be happy. Look at what the manager done. They're always looking for different avenues to, when shit hits the fan, to say, oh, but we pressed on. Oh, but, you know, at least we pushed the European champions to the semi-finals, and then we got eliminated. It's not that bad.
It was,
you know,
our first season back in it, guys.
Yeah, and like, that's what it is. Just be openly and honest about it. Like, that's what it is. If you genuinely believe Arsenal are going to win the league, say that. If you genuinely believe Arsenal can win the Champions League, say that. But if you don't believe it, don't criticize people for having the same opinion as you, whether that's rival fans like myself or whether that's fellow Arsenal fans like you too. And in regards to the Champions League, of course, the preference is, if your team is quality, of course, you ain't too pressed, like you said, but you have your preference, because you brought it back to Manchester United and Fergie. And like, yeah, I had my preferences those times who we played in a certain draw. Always bring me the easiest draw. That's always my preference, but I'm not completely shook. You know, from an Arsenal fan's perspective, it's like, yeah, of course, you want Dortmund and maybe Barca and, I don't know, not PSG, Atletico over your side. You ain't really trying to see City.
No, I don't want Atleti, bro. No.
You don't want Atleti. I see, I've tried to think, but you don't want City or Madrid. You want City, Madrid over the other side of the draw, because they draw the quarterfinals and the semifinals together. So, like, you want City, Madrid over the other side, PSG.
Yeah, if we're not getting Real Madrid in the quarters, it's rigged. Yeah, but this lot, we're all calling for Madrid. We don't fear anyone. Football heritage is a load of rubbish. Northside's got all the receipts, bruv. I've seen them.
Yeah. And that's right. Where you don't, like no, but you then, ain't trying to see Madrid.
Right, no. Through past Porto, which is cool. I'm happy we're through. Yeah, but this lot are going on like we've just won it. Yeah, now it's bring on Dortmund. But I thought you wanted Madrid. My fan cam title was bring on Real Madrid.
Pretty good.
Yeah, bring them on.
That's
bring them on.
If I'm an Arsenal fan, I'm saying bring
it on. When we got in the Champions League, this lot were doing the utmost, yeah, to sit there and dismiss any team in Europe. Yeah, and saying this, it's not a tough competition this year. Yeah, the only team that we really fear is Man City. Yeah, cool. Did you watch that last night? Did you watch Atleti, yeah? Yeah, did you watch that? Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah, you don't want to be playing Atleti, bruv. Trust me. They've not lost a knockout stage game at home under Simeone. They've never lost a knockout stage in the Champions League against anyone, yeah, under Simeone. And he's been there, what, 12 years?
Did City not beat them last year?
Not in the knockouts, no.
Was it not in the knockouts? Did they not? I swear City played. Was it not Atletico Madrid? Oh, I stand correct.
No, they played Real Madrid, they beat. But they ain't lost a knockout game at home, yeah, in the Champions League under Simeone. And this lot are all giving it, oh yeah, this competition's crap. It's crap, guys. Oh, they did beat him in knockouts. That's fake then.
Yeah. I thought so.
No, don't worry, just keep saying it. It sounds great. Lies spread quicker. Yeah, and everyone believes it. So yes, it's true, guys.
Yeah, I swear City beat them. They beat them in the home leg, and I think they beat them 1-0 in the away leg. I think Foden scored. Like I say, the chat will let me know better than me. But yeah, I remember they played them both. I remember, but this point still stands. It's probably one defeat. It's probably that one defeat in the past 10, 11 years or whatever the case may be.
Inter Milan, it was end-to-end that game last night in the first half. Second half, Atleti just pushed up and pressed them off the park. Yeah, they got through a couple of times. Yeah, but you just knew the goal was coming. Knew the goal was coming. I've been to that ground, mate. That ground is crazy. Yeah, it's mad loud as well. There you go. They drew Man City. at the in Madrid.
Okay, they drew that. It was 1-0 nil at Madrid. Okay, fair. I remember they played each other.
Well, maybe that's that is true then.
Yeah, you could be right. Hey,
bro, 12 years he's been manager and they ain't lost in Madrid in a knockout game. Yeah, and this fan base is saying, "Oh, but bring on Bayern, bring on what? Bring on Bayern."
You better hope you get Dortmund or Barcelona.
Hey, bro, bring on the biggest club in it, Real Madrid.
Joe, because you
come on, because this fan base need a humbling, and if we get through past Real Madrid, then I might start believing we can win it.
Then maybe the stars aren't aligning if you get past Madrid, but you ain't trying to see Madrid.
We ain't getting past Madrid if we get them. Yeah, Vinny Junior against Ben White. What?
Hey,
what? Rodrigo up against a politician, bro. Yeah, turn it in. Yeah, get out of here, man. Luka Modric coming off the bench. Nah, bro. Come on, do me a favor. Yeah, PSG are beatable. I agree, they are beatable. But the problem is they've got a turtle up front that can do it at any time, just like that.
And that's exactly, I was saying this legit yesterday when I was saying I favor Arsenal against PSG. But with Kylian Mbappe, they have the best player on the pitch over 180 minutes. If he turns it on for a half, can be game over title, but he's that good. So it's like, why would you want to get Real Madrid? Dortmund.
Bro, that World Cup final, bro, the way he performed against, bro, then I thought, nah, this guy's a beast. This guy.
Yeah, same. I didn't rate him that highly. That final, he went well up in my estimation, mate.
Because I've been a super big fan of his already, and that just elevated further because he was quiet for the vast majority of that game, and then boom, 10-minute spell. Drags his team back into it, and you're not trying to in a knockout tie. You're not trying to see that. You're not trying to. Why? Hey, like I say, Dortmund or Barcelona.
Mbappe up against Ben White, bruv. I'm sorry,
nah. But he comes from a farmers league,
the McDonald's league,
and then we're struggling against the Portuguese Burnley. Isn't that a farmers
who league? Put the ball in the Porto net? Who put the ball? Oh, only one player deal over 210 minutes. Okay, cool. Do you know what? We didn't have a shot on target. Yeah, after the 81st minute. Do you know that?
Was it after the 81st?
Is it? I didn't know.
Jesus came off the bench on the 80th minute. He had a shot straight away. We didn't have another shot on target after that.
Crazy.
We only had four shots on target in two legs.
Yeah, both teams, that was defenses on top, because I think they only had like five shots on target over the two legs or something crazy like that. I'd say defensively, very, very good. Paul just need a player who gives them that X factor going forward. Then they had to have a very good side.
Did you watch the game?
Yeah. I watched it.
I just want to ask you a question as a neutral,
Go on.
I've already said this to Arsenal fans, but some of them get triggered. What did you learn from that game, any different to how we can break down low blocks or mid blocks? What did you see?
I didn't see anything new.
You're not going to get views like that. You have to praise us, mate.
Yeah, I didn't say anything new. What I will say is, though, I will praise Odegaard because he looked your most... He set up the goal. It was a quality pass. And he looked the most likely in the entire game. He was head and shoulders your best attacker. Anything good, even if it didn't result in a shot on target or even a shot, everything good went through him. And he's someone who's been ghost of guard, accused of going missing in bigger games. But that game, he stood up, like I said. And it was a good goal as well. You scored. Good finish by Trossard as well. But yeah, you're going to struggle.
I told everyone he was scoring, bruv. Do you know what I'm saying? My baller, bruv. My baller. Right, big up to everyone locked in, man. 600 in here. Smash these likes up. Big up to Granit Xhaka. He's always in my chat. I don't know if he's finished training for the day, but he's top of the league. He's going to win the league. But big up, man. If Porto was a tiny bit better, we didn't qualify. Yeah, and then teams left in a better than Porto. Hope this helps all the positive fans. Bro, it's true. Yeah, like I said, the most experienced player on the pitch kept Trossard onside. If he steps up, we don't score. Mm-hmm. It's as simple as that. We had four shots here. We had one from Saka that was a P-roller straight to the keeper. We had the goal. We had one from Mjødegaard, P-roller straight at the goalkeeper. Yeah, and then we had the Jesus shot, which was a good save. That's all we did in 210 minutes. That's it.
Yeah.
People are going on like, bring on anyone. Nah. Yeah, you do that against that lady, watch what happens. Yeah, because they got Morata up front. They got Griezmann that can score at any point. Yeah, out of nothing. They got Depay that come off the bench, scored a cracking goal yesterday. Yeah, do you know what I'm saying? They've got players that they can whip a ball into the box and they can win headers. Yeah, Morata can win headers. Yeah, he might be a donkey. Yeah, but I'll tell you now, you throw 10 balls in the box, Pauls, then he's scoring one of them. Yeah, and they'll just keep spamming the crosses. Yeah, keep hitting him on the break. Like, nah, man, it's crazy. Big up to Pear, bruv. I didn't see a plan B. when things do not go our way. Only players balling, bailing Arteta out. Also, not a single team in our win streak except Liverpool has had anything going for them. Let's see against City. True story, bro. True story. And thank you for that, mate. Big up Granit Xhaka again. Watch Dan Potts' channel on Deji Spurs said, Europe is so dusty, Spurs will easily be in the semi, even West Ham can. Big Ange made them know. Bro, these Spurs fans...
Shout out to Deji, man.
These Spurs fans are shameless. They were phoning Mo on his show last night, laughing at him. Bro, why are you hating from outside the club? You can't even get in. That's what I'm saying.
Hey, shout out to Judge Mo, though. Them clips were hilarious. Shout out to Judge Mo. Oh, man. Them clips.
Big up to Darrell as well. If Porto had a young Falcao, they would have won by four.
Paul just needed that little something going forward. I was saying this as I was watching, even 10, 15 minutes into the game on my watch along, I was like, Paul, we're not scoring here. The only way that Paul will go through is if this is no. Just didn't really have too much. But like I said, I see why. Is it not like 17 goals you've conceded all season? I see why.
Yeah, decent team, man. Decent team. But we knew this anyway, because like we watch football. we've watched football for years. We know these Portuguese teams and Spanish teams keep the ball. Yeah, they keep the ball and they're quick on the counter attack. Yeah, and they do the dark arts. Look how many times their players are on the floor over two legs. Yeah, like it's crazy. But yeah. Are you looking for in the draw then, North Side? Yeah, you looking for Dortmund or Barca?
Real Madrid, man. You know what I'm saying?
Real Madrid, bro. Bring them on. I'm being serious. Bring on Real Madrid.
Look, you are a troll, man.
I'm not even lying. If you rig me up to a lie detector right now, I want Real Madrid. And it'll say, yeah, it's telling the truth. Bring Real Madrid on there. And I'll tell you why. Number one, it'd be a very good game. Yeah. Number two, if we lose, this fan base are in the bin. Yeah, because of them running their gums to the 14 times European champions about they're no good anymore. They're not as good as everyone thinks they are. They've lost twice in all comps all season. They've conceded hardly any goals all season. And they've had about 30-odd injuries this season. Yeah, so, bring them on. If we beat them, that's a big, big green tick next to Mikel Arteta's name that he's got over the line against the best team in the world, in my opinion. I know City won the treble, but this is an elite-level football club as well, and against an elite-level manager. So bring them on. Let's see how good we actually are, isn't it?
The thing is, there's a couple of ways it can go. For example, if they're calling out for Dortmund, if we don't beat Dortmund, what's the excuse? That was the team you wanted. What's the excuse? You can't back out of that now because you said that's the team you wanted. That's the team you believe that we can beat. If we don't win, you're getting called out. You know what I mean? But then if we were to get a team like City, that would derail everything. Because if City knock us out of the Champions League, we are not winning the league. This club is too emotional and the fan base are too emotional. If they were to knock us out of the Champions League, it is done. It's done. We already saw the pressure last season where we couldn't even beat Nottingham Forest when they beat us 1-0. Arsenal, in terms of mentality, are very sensitive, bro. Very sensitive, bro. Once this
fan base... We're mentality monsters, mate.
yo, we don't do Terry Traction around here. We don't do Terry Traction.
Mentality monsters is jokes. Mentality monsters
Terry
is
dopamine.
Good.
We don't do that, man. We don't do that. The Terry dopamine. Listen, let them do what they got to do, innit? But... that's the thing. Like, what's man going to say? Because I think that would affect our Premier League run as well if City knock us out. Because all of a sudden, I think the team will start not believing and the manager will start not believing. But I don't really care. Give me, actually, you know what? Give me Bayern. Because that is the main team that I saw them saying, oh, Bayern ain't the same. Bayern's dead. Bayern's this. All right, cool. If Harry Kane knocks us out of the Champions
Revenge
League.
Revenge settings, man. Revenge.
Yeah.
What are we saying?
Doing it for you the teams, you guys.
You might not want revenge, man. Revenge on Bayern.
Mate, the disrespect for Bayern is crazy. Yeah, Harry Kane, Musiala, Kimmich, Sane, like they got some top players, man. Yeah, Goretzka, they got some very good players. Yeah, they're not that great in terms of league form. Yeah, bro, trust me. At any point, they can turn it on. At any point, and not only that, they've got Müller as well. They've been there, done it, won it. A lot of their squad have won the Champions League. Yeah, the disrespect is crazy. And let's be real, it's the only thing they got left to play for.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. It'd be interesting to see because Bayern aren't Bayern of old, but they still have players of quality. So it's going to be interesting whoever you get. Nah, it won't be 5-1, though. I don't think it's a 5-1 difference.
5-1 three times in a row against this
one, mate. Yeah, I don't think it'll be 5-1. As much as I'd love to see it, I don't think it'll be 5-1. But if you do draw Manchester City, that means you play them three times in a month. So that would be interesting. That's the draw I'm hoping for. I want to see City-Arsenal. I need that. That's the one I want.
Big up to this mega mutant in my chat who keeps spamming my chat. You're all being fake. Yeah, shut up, Io de puta. Yeah, how about go and watch AFTV, bruv, and they'll gnaw you off if you want, you mutant. Have a double unskippable. Bosh. Why are you here? Real talk, why are you here?
Yeah, the
title quite clearly says Arsenal are not scary, world-class, or unstoppable. So you decided I'll click on it and tell this guy he's fake. Bruv, go to a game, yeah, do it 500-plus times, come back to me and then tell me I'm fake. Io de puta. Yeah? Get out of here, man. Ili boya.
It's definitely one of my next titles on Arsenal. Arsenal scary. Hey, what is it? Scary
in the title, bruv, and you'll get mad views.
Arsenal scary and unstoppable. All right, I'm gonna add that.
If I didn't support Arsenal, I'd do it. you know what I'm saying, let me set up another channel,
bruv. Man got 66k views, yeah, on his second channel. He had about 1,000 subs at the time, yeah. 66k views. Arsenal were scary, bro. It's lit.
Someone told me, I'm not gonna expose who it was, but they were like, yo, if you just write this, and it's funny because then you said it, and I was like, someone already told me that did that, and he's like, just write Arsenal unstoppable. And then he just kept doing that. And then he told somebody else that he does lives with as well. And every video, yeah, is more than, way more. It's like triple the amount of subscribers that he got every time he does that. Arsenal unstoppable. Arsenal unbelievable. Arsenal, somebody please stop Arsenal and all that.
Arsenal needs stopping. Arsenal needs world class. Here's why Arsenal will win the league. Like,
five things we learned from Arsenal. You know what I'm
People is one of my next titles. Yesterday was
the next title put in there. Arsenal was scary.
Yesterday it was are the stars aligning for Arsenal. Now I'm going to try this scary and unstoppable and see how it goes. Yeah. I'll probably do it next week.
Trust me, you'll have more views on that video than the previous 10. Guaranteed.
Put the tactical board with the arrows and the all of that, yeah? And the thumbnail, trust me, it'll blow. You know what I'm saying? All of that nonsense. That's what they like. That's what they like. You know what I'm saying?
Apparently Ben White's got a new...
I've been seeing you, you know.
Ben White's got a new deal today. I haven't seen him. Everyone's saying the video's cringe, so we'll have a look at that in a second, people. Hey, smash these likes up, guys. Smash these likes up. Make sure you sub to both the guys' channels. Link in the title. Big up to Riku as well. Northside, who's the best player you've seen in Portuguese league?
There's a lot. Gaetan, Luizão, Facão was a beast. Jonas was a beast. Obviously, Eusebio was before my time. Loads of them, man. Di Maria balled out when he was first there. It's too many, man. Too many. You know what I mean? Too many. Some of them, you know, were amazing in the league. Others obviously went abroad. But yeah, man. Jackson Martinez as well was good, the Colombian. Who else is good? Loads of them, man. Loads. But Gaetan was special. And Luizão as well. What a solid defender, man, with that slamming. The Brazilian Vin Diesel, bro. He was good, man. He was good. But yeah.
Yeah, big up to everyone, man.
I mean, probably Rui Costa.
Yeah, decent as well. Proper player. Big up to Demetrius. He says, I think we'll get Atleti. Boy, if they think that Porto was stinky, yeah, good luck. Good luck against that low block.
Would you say that Atletico Madrid are kind of like a better version of Porto? Like defensively very, very good, but then have more going forward?
Yeah, because they've got Griezmann that can... His goal last night was insane. The way he spun on that and flicked that, mad finish, man. Yeah, mad finish, but... They've also got Morata, and he's having a good season. He got subbed yesterday. He dropped a stinker yesterday, but he's a player that when you least expect him to do something, he does something. But then when you start scoring and scores like 6-7 games in a row, you think, right, Morata's on fire. He's going to have a good game today, and then he flops. Yeah, but at any point, they can whip a ball in, and he's winning the header. Do you know what I'm saying? And he's quick as well. For somebody that like is a bit of a lump, he's pretty quick as well. Yeah, and the way they play, they've got Lino down the left. Yeah, I've been at a semi-final at the Emirates in the Europa League against that lady. Yeah, and after about 10 minutes, they had their left-back sent off, and then Simeone got sent off a minute later. So down to 10 men for about 80 minutes. We absolutely battered them. Oblak turned into the best keeper the world's ever seen, bruv. Yeah, save after save after save, and then they nicked a draw right at the end. Yeah, Koscielny kicked it off his own head, and Griezmann went clean through. Yeah, and then we went to their ground, and it was like we were 5-0 up on coasting. We'd already qualified for the final, and then Diego Costa scored 1-0. Yeah, so and that was then. Yeah, and they've probably got I wouldn't say they've probably got a better team now, but they've still got an equally as tough team to beat. Yeah, and that's what he does. He just gets his team. Yeah, like very difficult to beat, but they have that little sprinkle of stardust as well with Griezmann. Yeah, and Raquel May as well, top player. They've got Lino, top player. Yeah, they Llorente, decent player as well. So yeah, man. Yeah, good luck if we get them. Yeah, they're a more polished and refined Porto. And they've been doing it for 12 years with the same manager, bruv.
True, true.
So yeah, keep away from them. I'm hoping for Dortmund, says Kool-Aid, the Barca fan. That's probably the best bet, otherwise you're getting pumped.
Yeah, I can say if you're an Arsenal fan, hope for Dortmund, that is the way forward. Dortmund is the way forward, 100%.
Right, Jadon Sancho dunking on us here at the Emirates.
That's Dortmund there. I think you beat Dortmund. As much as I'd love that, but I think you beat Dortmund.
Do you know what's funny, though, yeah? Like Northside said, if we get Dortmund and get knocked out,
yeah, oh, that'd be hilarious. That'd be hilarious.
Also, we want the away game first. Yes. Yeah, because if we play at home first, it doesn't matter who we get. That's going to be tricky. Yeah, then because they're not going to come and try and play football no matter who it is. They're just going to come and sit back. Yeah, and then they're going to lose. Yeah, try and beat us away. And if we lose at home to any of these teams, doesn't matter which team it is, we're out. If we get the first leg at home.
I agree with that.
We're out.
If you lose at home to whoever, I can see you going out 100%. Especially the way you performed in Porto as well. But your home form is very good. So you see, I think you'll get Madrid or Bayern though. It'll be one of those two.
Big up to Miles, man. He says, this is the second best channel for Arsenal fans. First is Rory Jennings and he don't even support Arsenal. I told you, they're all at it, bro. They're all at it. I think I'll take one locked in. That's enough of cooking Arsenal. But yeah, let's talk about your club, bro. Let's talk about United. What's going on in Disneyland up in Manchester, bro?
Rashford linked with a move away. That's probably the biggest news. The PSG reported the interest. This happened last year before he got his new deal as well. PSG want him. I don't know if it's a reliable source or not, but hey, PSG want him, take him. You're losing Mbappe, come get Mbappe light. You feel me? If you want a replacement Mbappe, hey, come get Marcus Rashford and come and take him. Other than that, I think Fabrizio also tweeted out yesterday that we're looking at a new left back in the summer. All for that, obviously. Nah, we good.
Go get. He does team huddles, mate, and it's very emotional.
Yeah, very, you don't like Manchester. He's good. He's been here once before. It's all right. You lot can keep Zinchenko because he helps with.
I mean, he's bringing the winning mentality. He's
and the winning mentality. The yes. Yeah. The winning mentality and the experience. Yeah, we do need a new left back. So yeah, that was good news. But other than that, not really much unless the chat say it. There hasn't really been much news. Uneventful win against Everton, two penalties. That's it. We got Liverpool on Sunday.
You probably prefer it like that. You know what I mean?
Outside, surprisingly, yeah. Like outside of the game, like our front four was McTominay, Bruno, Rashford, Garnacho. That's not doing anything against anybody. That fits no style whatsoever. Doesn't matter if you're playing on a counter attack, if you're playing a low block and keeping possession. That front four is not doing anything. Hopefully, Hoyland is back soon. And yeah, the biggest thing is obviously Liverpool on Sunday, which is not going to be a great game, but it's just about getting through. We have to get through. I think we'll get through, but I think it'll go pens. I think it'll go pens.
Just believe in it.
Hey, when you believe Arsenal will win the league, I believe in Manchester United Northside. How about that? That should be the thing. There we go. When you believe Arsenal will win the league, when you drink the Kool-Aid with Arsenal, I believe in Manchester United and Temple.
Bro, don't worry, man. They're doing it for Klopp. They're doing it for Klopp, guys. They're doing it for Klopp. So you're finished this weekend. You might as well not even bother watching the game. Yeah, don't worry about it. Just make loads of videos over the weekend about how great Arsenal are. Have a nice carefree weekend. Just chill. Go out with the family. Yeah, like just relax, bruv. Yeah, Arsenal ain't playing because this man is out yet again. Funny enough, to Liverpool. Scary Liverpool. But don't worry, man. It was just a blip, guys. But yeah, man, you lot are getting battered this weekend.
Oh, yeah, it's going to be peak. It could really get ugly. The only thing that we have a decent record against them at home. The place will be jumping because it's FA Cup. That's pretty much it. If I didn't do content creating, I would not be watching, though. I would not watch this game. But since I'm here, unfortunately, I got to do a watch along and watch the game. And again, it's just hope. It's just hope that they have an off day and we have an on day and we manage to get past them.
Even if you have an on day, you've got to score at least twice.
No. 0-0 penalties lead. You know what I'm saying? We can go through on penalties. You lot just went through on penalties. If we have an on day, we could just draw the game. draw the game, defend for our lives like we did away to them, get to penalties, and then boom, all set piece, all referee mistake. It's definitely due a referee mistake. What, absolutely.
Mentality monsters, yeah, if you beat them on penalties.
Yeah. I wouldn't say all that. Yeah, I don't like these words. I don't like these phrases you are throwing out on the outside and these words. Yeah. I don't like this. Believe mentality monsters. No, just get through. That's it.
Liverpool embarrassed and out.
Yes, that's it. I'm saying that, that's what I maybe did. I'm missing the trick with those, with these things. This is due to, I would say this now, because of what happened in the City Liverpool game with the whole VAR and robbery. This has got a VAR decision for Manchester United written all over it, 100%. So they can scream robbery again, even though Diaz missed 2 one-on-ones and Shabal's like missed a free header. But it's the ref's fault that they didn't
get it. It's the ref's fault, yeah, man.
It's the ref's fault.
It's football, bro. It's the easiest era to play Premier League football and manage Premier League.
You can just blame referees. It's like, no, Diaz missed 2 sitters. Shabazzlai missed the sitter. Same way Foden missed the one-on-one as well. It's like, it's on your players. Forget whether it was a penalty. You're not out there blaming VAR. No, hold your players accountable. That is the problem. Yes.
You need that's what you need, man. You need your manager to have his meat fondled with, serenaded. And
we've
only lost one game since, and that was to Porto.
Hey, if anyone needs a trip to Dubai, it's me. You know what I'm saying? I've been to watch these man all this season. I need the trip to Dubai. Need to go back. That's what it is. Jesus.
Yeah, that could be a good title for you. Klopp's fairy tale is over.
Klopp's fairy tale over. Yeah. Hey, these sensationalized YouTube titles are hilarious.
Yeah, but it works though, man. Instagram have been doing it for years. Do you know what I mean? I'm going to share this Ben White announcement video in a second, yeah? I've just seen the first couple of seconds. Hair flick is at it already, bruv. In 2 seconds in, he's flicking his hair, bruv. Go and get your hair chopped if you have to keep flicking it, bruv. Like, real talk. Yeah, it's obviously too long. Yeah, but anyway. Big up to everyone locked in. Big up Kool-Aid, man. I fear no team in the Champions League. We are Barca. That's... Yeah, bruv, you've got El Sapo as manager, bruv. Yeah, the toad, bruv. Yeah, and again, crying about, if we had lost, yeah, it would have been all over the headlines that I'm not good enough. Why is he so emotional, bruv? Like, real talk, that manager is, he'd be perfect manager for Premier League football, Xavi. Yeah, because he don't like the fact that the media called him out for his bullshit. Right, and he just wants all the adulation. Bro, come to the Premier League. Yeah, come to the Premier League, bro.
That pressure is different, man. That's what it is. That pressure is different. And we watching managers crumble under it. Because if you would have lost, you would have received criticism. And rightfully so, but you didn't. So therefore, you're receiving praise because your team went through. That's how football is. Fine margins. You win, you get praised. You lose, you get criticized. Life. Yeah,
unfortunately, in England, it doesn't matter whether you win, lose, or draw. You're praised anyway. And anyone who don't praise is negative and toxic and fuck off down the lane. Yeah. But if you stumble across this video, mate, Premier League, you will be fine, my friend. You look mad, stressed all the time. Yeah, kicking off on the touchline, kicking off with journos. Yeah, he's quit. Yeah, you know, just bro, come to the Premier League. I'm sure there is a team for you in the Premier League. There will be no pressure. You will have 4 years to implement a process that will never come to the end. Yeah, and it'll be great. And the fans will just say, just back him. If Xavi wants him, I want him. It's cool.
He can go to Brighton. He'll fit in at Brighton. You know what I mean?
Yeah. If you're not at a big club, you're fine. But if you're in the Premier League and you're at a big club, hey, the content, you will get backed more by your fans. But hey, the content creators who are criticizing you, it's a wrap. You two with Arsenal, Rant and Saeed, imagine, it's over. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? It's over. Like, I can't deal with that type of criticism. It's a wrap if you're doing a bad job, for real. And hey,
he could end up at Man United. Would you take him at United?
No, absolutely not. No. Absolutely not. Send him Arsenal.
That's who Man said he doesn't speak English. Well, neither did Bielsa. You know what I mean? So it's fine.
Oh, yeah, because Bielsa had the translator, didn't he?
Yeah. Just get the bucket out. Oh, look at him with the bucket. Oh, well, let's start selling bucket merch.
Hey, neither did Poch. Neither did Poch at Southampton, bro. He had the translator.
Yeah.
Translator.
You don't need to speak English, man. Just get the ball out. Yeah, and just start moving some bits around. Show him on the iPad. I want you to do this, guys. You need to put the ball in the net. This net, not this net.
No, the classic one from Una Emery, the one I remember was, sometimes, good evening, sometimes we need the rain sometimes the sun, sometimes the rain. And the interviewer's like, what? The rain.
Good evening. Good evening. Hey, easy, easy. Like Dino says in the chat, just ask them how they feel, bro. It don't matter. They can write it on the board. Mm. Have you seen that, where they've written it on the board, the Arsenal
players?
That
was this. Yeah. What have they written on the board?
They ask the players how it makes them feel to play at the Emirates. And they're all writing happy, yeah, joyous, excited. It's like you're going around the play school, yeah. All the, come here, Timothy. It's your turn to write on the board now. How does it make you feel playing in the sand pit? Okay, if you write your name, if you write it on the board yourself, and would you like to do it? You can have some jelly and ice cream if you do it yourself. Get out of here, man! What's wrong with this club? Yeah, what is wrong with this club? Yeah, get out of here. Okay, no, leave Samantha's pen alone. You've got your own Timothy. Like, get out of here.
It's mad.
Yeah, crazy. Team full of weirdos, bro. Like, seriously. Yeah, can you imagine Sir Alex Ferguson? Yeah, standing there saying, "Right, Roy Keane, you're next." How does it make you feel to play at Old Trafford? Right, yeah. He'd headbutt him.
Yeah. He's not having that. He's not. What was the purpose? Was he trying to improve morale? Is that what that was?
Yeah, he's a motivational speaker, bro. That's what it is. He's trying to, yes, it's amazing. Like, yeah, man. This is the same team that wheeled out speakers before Anfield and bellowed out Never Walk Alone to go to Anfield and get pammed 4-1.
That was a one. Come on, Timothy, do you want some jelly and ice cream?
If you write your name on it, you can extra 5 minutes in the sandpit.
Damn.
Seriously, man. Listen, if we win the league, it was all worth it, isn't it?
Worked it? Yeah, it worked. That's what it is. Like Xavi can play today. If Arteta wins the league, guess what? He'll get praise. All of these things worked. But if you don't win the league, guess what? He'll receive criticism.
Yeah, but why do we treat our players like this?
I got a gold star today because I wrote, I'm happy to play at the Emirates. It makes me feel great. Yeah, like, get out of here. I'll share it on the screen in a minute. I'll share it. So, mate, it's mad. It is mad.
Oh, my God. Do you want Bitty?
Not Bitty now, Bitty later.
Bitty later. Oh, shit.
Too funny, man. Too funny. Big up LJ, man. Arsenal gave me stress on my birthday with pens. PS, who runs the AFC Twitter account? Everyone is holding strays. Poor Judge Mo.
Yeah, they got a Judge Mo, man. His head was fried.
He's funny, man.
Shout out, Judge Mo.
He got cooked. Big up LJ for another one. Flawless. It's written in the stars for you.
Yeah, it's written in the stars for Arsenal. No. Arsenal, man. The stars are aligning for Arsenal. Premier League, Champions League, not Manchester United, man.
That's your next title.
Yeah, that's my title. Yesterday, it's at the stars aligning for Arsenal. That was yesterday. 100%. That was yesterday.
Man's not on these buzzwords and that. He's already at it, bro.
Stars aligning for Arsenal because Tony said it to me last week. And then I've just been running with it ever since. At the stars aligning for Arsenal. All right, let's have the conversation, are they? But yeah, next, definitely. Arsenal, unstoppable, scary.
Yeah, man. Big up to Go AM as well. Lucky Arsenal won. Otherwise, Meat Golf Arteta would be asking the team to show them where Porto touched it. Oh, Jesus Christ. Yeah,
that's crazy. Go AM. That is wild. That is wild.
You're tapped. Big up, though, for the super chat. You're wild. Big up Tiger Claws as well. Do you think Pep can win the Champions League with the current Barca team? No. Although he'd probably get... He'd probably get to the semis, and I don't think they're going to get to the semis. All right, listen, you never know.
If they draw Dortmund, we got a shot.
Yeah, they got some good players, Barca, but that manager they've got, mate, he's no good, bruv. Let me share this video. Let me share this video, guys. This is Benjamin White's announcement video. Yeah. Right, one sec. Let's go back, guys.
Too much. He's a bit mysterious, but
fucking hell, most zesty football club in the world.
How come they all said warrior? That's how you know it's scripted.
Three or four in a row said warrior. Yeah, they're probably holding up the board behind the camera.
Oh, Dennis, yeah. Like this. Warrior! Warrior!
And again, maybe Benjamin is a warrior.
Fabio and Martinelli and Ramsdale, them three did not want to be there. You could tell straight away. When family goes mysterious, like they're
wearing that team coming up. Colours, bruv. So you know they've dragged him in off of a day off.
Why has it always got to be us, man? Why, bro?
Because they celebrating the new deal, Northside, man. New deal for your warrior of a player, consistent, team leader, dependable.
Great trainer.
Funny.
No, Declan Rice said he had nothing to say because you barely know him, bro. You've only come this year. Like, why are we forcing this? You don't know my guy. You know what I mean? Like, what's going on? You've only just come. Like, Ramsdale went like this. Warrior, right? You know, it's like, I don't even get to see games. I'm not used to getting up at this time. I don't even do training anymore. I don't see minutes. What am I doing up? You know what I'm saying? It was forced. You could see it's forced, bro.
Damn.
Look at us on this live and look at them. It's not natural.
Yeah, because they ain't naturals talking in front of camera like we are. That's what that is. Like, we cool talking in front of a camera, like, answering questions. They're not. I say the warrior, man. That's what they say.
Now, my club is, the players are always going up to the camera, Odegaard taking the flipping camera, taking photos, doing
physical. Yeah, he's the exception. I'm talking your Ramsdale, Vieira, who else was there? I'm talking them lot. Like, Odegaard fits the bill.
Mm.
Yeah, Ramsdale. It was Ramsdale who said
plump. We're a family, guys.
I just don't understand. Why has it got... I just don't get it. Like... I don't care about these, like, revealing... Bro, why are we... I don't, what's the point? I don't get it. Like, why?
Yeah. Hey, no side.
Why? Like, you're renewing Belief. Your contract. Just take a picture. I'm done. Like, why do we need to do all of this? Like,
hey, it's for the team, man. It's team bonding. It's to build team morale, like you told me.
I guarantee if I go and read all the comments. Oh, we love you, Benny Blanco.
That's it.
Oh, yeah, he stays again. Oh, wow, Benny Blanco. But this is why they do it. This is why they tweet like they're talking to toddlers. Yeah, your club does it. Our club does it. Tottenham do it. Tottenham are the worst, by the way. Yeah, we're a family. No, you're not. I guarantee if you email your football club right now and say, I'm skink and you loan me 10 grand, yeah, they won't even reply. So you're not a family, are you? Yeah. Like, yeah, my roof's leaking. Well, funny enough, so's yours. They'll reply and say, so's ours.
Yeah. Facts. We've got the same problems. How about you fix the roof?
If you ain't seen this, I can't believe you ain't seen this for this. Watch this. Arsenal players' dressing room notes on how playing at the Emirates makes them feel.
I saw this.
Oh, I love that, man. hey, someone at me this on Twitter, please. I beg. God, that's me, flawless. Someone send this through to me.
Hey, look.
Proud, confident, Reece enjoyment, Nelson, excited. Nelson says
proud. Thomas Partey feels good, but it's better than being at home. Pleasure, says Zinchenko. Obviously, he ain't getting it at home. Because like a special Trossard, magical guys.
Love that. What's that one there? It was that pleasure. Okay, love that. Mm,
pleasure, guys. There's Zinchenko. Pleasure. Unique. Yeah, unique, says Cedric Suarez. Well done, mate. You're on 85 grand a week. Who else we got here? Excited. Privileged. Yeah, Ben White, privileged. Like, get out of here, man.
That's a nice gesture, man. You know what I'm saying? That's sweet of him.
The Arsenal nursery, the Arsenal creche, bruv. Colney creche. It's good, isn't it? It's good here, isn't it? But listen, we are going to wrap this up, guys. It's been funny. Big up to Daryl. Was that the signing video? True Hollywood stories. Why? Bro, I don't know why we're so cringe. I think what it is, is the fact that they know this fan base are weird.
Yeah, it gains traction. And that will get
so much traction. Yeah, because they're playing on people's emotions. Yeah, and they do all of this subconscious, like, you know, with the armband they're all running around on in the other day. Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah, you don't see Real Madrid wearing that. They just fucking win, and they refuse to wear it. Yeah, it's true. They're the only club that refuse it, bro. They say, bollocks, yeah, give us the fine. They take a fine every year. 30 grand fine from UEFA every year. They refuse to
wear it. What's this for? Refuse to wear what? What do they refuse to wear?
The rainbow thing.
Ah, right, okay.
They refuse to do it every year, bro. They're like, no, we're a football club. Fair. Yeah, we're here to win.
You should
only club on the planet to do it every year. Yeah, crazy. But instead, our lot. And if you look at these football stadiums now, yeah, they're everywhere. In the corners of the tunnel and that is all subconscious. Mm. Yeah, subconscious. The same with we're a family. So now anyone who goes against it, you're fake. We're a family. We're changing the culture. We're together. Why do you think they do these team huddles before kickoff, first and second? You just done 15 minutes in the dressing room. Yeah, you come back out. Oh, Porto ain't even on the pitch. You're standing there all cuddling. Fucking turn it in. This is a friendship circle, guys. Yeah, all hold hands, Ring a rose, get out of here, man. Seriously.
It's very kumbaya, my lord, type stuff.
And then what happens is, whether you win, lose, or draw, that can get posted out and with the graphic with the score together. So if you lose, together. So now, it doesn't matter that we've lost because they're together. Yeah, we're a family. We tried. Yeah, Luton Town last night, yeah? Look at the state of this. Yeah, Luton Town bottled a 3-0 lead.
They were 3-0 up against Bournemouth.
Yeah, watch this. Yeah, this is crazy, bro. Luton Town, after the game. The post after the game. Where are we? Yeah. Here we go. They posted the graphic. Yeah, defeat on the road. Yeah, you should be ashamed of yourselves even posting that. Yeah, defeat on the road, and it's a player on his knees. You know, crouching down, like, with his head down. Yeah, so it's like, again, I'll share the post. Yeah, so again, it's like, we tried. Yeah, we tried. It's all subconscious. Yeah. Look, full time. Defeat on the road. How about we bottled it? Yeah, why are they even posting? They should be fucking ashamed of themselves. 3-0 up and you lose 4-3.
Interaction? That's what it is.
Let's read some of the comments. You mean, yeah, see, look, rival fan, you deserve to be relegated. Yeah, look, 3-0 up after 45 minutes.
How?
And it's just full of rival fans calling them bottle jobs.
3-0 and you effort up, no wonder you get relegated.
It's always off the player like that. What about when he's leaving the stadium in his Land Rover, Range Rover, or Merc? What about that? Mm-hmm. We got defeated, but we're still paying your wage for you to have this lavish lifestyle. What about that? Because that's not going to pull on your heartstrings. That's going to make you start thinking, wait, hold on. We just got defeated, yet man's still living in luxury.
Mm.
They're not going to show that. They're going to show that because it's
they got to show that they care. They got to show the visual that shows that they care. They know what they're doing. Like these.
And again, it's subconscious. So it plays on the emotional connection to your football club. That because that picture will be how Luton Town fans look and feel in their house.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it is.
Yeah, we bottled it. So now they're putting that out. Oh, well, at least the players feel it as well, guys.
Because they do play on it. They do play on the fact that we all love our football club. So there's that emotional attachment.
Hey, Tottenham have put their season ticket price up 6%. Why? When was the last time we fucking won anything?
They put their season... Ain't they already the most expensive place to watch football in the Premier League as it is? And they put it up 6%.
In Europe. And they've put it up another 6%. Why? And their fans will go, but we've got our Tottenham back.
They're the most... It's the most expensive place to watch football in Europe. And they ain't even in Europe.
Bro, they were jumping around like they won the title at the weekend. They went from fifth to fifth. Yeah, what a great win on the road, guys. We won 4-0 against Villa. And what? You're fifth. Yeah, big up to this guy. Imagine hating because someone is privileged to play for the team. Wild take. Well, it ain't really because the guy couldn't give two fucks whether he plays for us or not, mate. Yeah? Do you genuinely think any of these players care that they play for Arsenal Football Club? Yeah, if you think that, you're gone, bruv. You're too far gone to be saved. Yeah, none of these players give two Fs about playing for this football club. None of them. Maybe Bukayo Saka because he come through the academy. Maybe the academy ones. Yeah, but all these other players that we've signed, they could not care less, bruv. Yeah, because guarantee right now, if the football club folds and football disappeared today, do you think they're going to be sitting at home crying? They ain't got nothing to do anymore. They're not. Yeah. They're going to be sitting there counting their millions in their mansion, bruv. They do not care. So when people get, but Van Persie went to United. He's a disgrace. He's a Judas. Guess what? Nobody cares. He don't care. It's a job.
Ben White doesn't even watch football.
Yeah, he don't even watch football, bro. Yeah, and you think he cares about the club?
Yeah, I think it's one of those. I think it's like you said. It's a job, and it's what works for you at that moment in time. If let's say Arsenal were to get relegated for something, like let's say they were. Had some city charges and got relegated. How many of the players are staying? He said, what have you done for me lately on both ends?
How many of them are taking a pay cut and saying, I'll play for the club for free until we get back on our feet? None of them.
I hear you. There's very, very few. I think it's, like I said, it's what you've done for me lately from the club perspective and players' perspective. People need to realize that. That's what football is. If a player all of a sudden is out of form for two seasons, you're gone. Same way if a club fall off, eventually your players move on. So what have you done for me lately, sport?
Absolute facts. Right, listen, who's live that we like real quick? Right, Rance, say less. Rance is live. When did he go live?
I think it was like 1:10, 1:15.
Still live, right? We're redirecting to Rance, guys. We're going to redirect to Rance. Northside, brother. Benfica tonight. I will be doing a watch-along as well for that. It's the only decent game of the early kickoffs. Like the rest of them are all pretty much dead and buried already, the ties. So yeah, man, I'll be sharing your stream later when you're losing. What else you got coming up, man? Link in the title, guys.
Yeah, nah, before this, Cooking Mo and his reaction. So yeah, check that out. Cooking Mo.
What time's that?
No, I've already done that. That was before this live.
You put that out.
And I redirected.
Oh, you done it already?
Yeah. And then I redirected to here. So yeah, anyone that didn't watch that can catch up with that. And then Benfica, we better win. But I don't think we will. But yeah, man, I got that. And then yeah, every day, man, putting out content. So yeah, man, love having me on. Big up Lee. Big up Flawless. Just believe, Flawless. Just believe.
Same to you, man. But echo was it to both of you, man. Believe. You know what I'm saying? The stars are aligning. Your team is unstoppable. Scary, scary hours for the rest of the Premier League and the rest of Europe. Hey, to Arsenal fans watching this, drink the Kool-Aid. I'm saying, and believe, look up in the sky and see that the stars are aligning. You're on for the big boy double.
All of the players are proud, excited, and feel privileged, guys. Yeah, so we nobody can stop us, guys. As long as you believe, you must believe in the team, guys. Big up to Demetrius as well. I don't know why, but I keep getting Ted Lasso vibes from my AFC. Bro, it's crazy. It's actually crazy. Flawless, love always, man. Link in the title for Flawless's channel, Sarcasm City TV. What you got coming up, man?
Yeah, big up, man. Much appreciated for having me as always. What we got coming up tonight? Probably at 11:45 p.m. Manchester United, Manchester City show, actually. So myself, my Don Vader, talking all things, both clubs. So yeah, just subscribe to the channel. And big up to everyone supporting as well, because the channel recently just went over 10K as well. So big up to everyone supporting, man. Past couple of days, so appreciate it. So yeah, and love for having me as always, Lee, and big up to the chat as well. But run up the likes here and hit the subscribe button on this channel as well.
Do the 10 attraction, man. You'll get to 20 real quick.
I'm expecting by the end of the season you to double that, flip that real quick.
That's the aim. That is the aim.
Keep putting the sensational titles, bruv. It's working for everyone. Yeah, working for everyone. We're going to redirect to Rants. He's live right now with Monts. So make sure you go and spam his chat with Lee Raid. I'll be back again for the Benfica game later on Lee Reacts. And then after that, I don't know whether to do Villa against Ajax or Leverkusen versus Carabag. I'm not sure yet, but we'll do one of them. So yeah, two watch-alongs later. We're out, people. Laters.
There you go.
Ten Hag in.